Hello again and welcome to the SOFiCAD video documentation. In this chapter, I will show you how to efficiently create rebar pointers and rebar sets in SOFiCAD. Rebar sets will help us to properly count and represent the detail shapes that we have created on the last chapter. Let us start with the easiest one, the pointer. On the creation menu we can configure, among other things, the number of bars that this pointer is going to count. We want to add this pointer as annotation for the bar 3 in the intersection AA. For this, we have to type in the corresponding bar mark, or, by clicking on this small button, we can select the item to annotate and SOFiCAD will read its bar mark for us. After creating a rebar set, or any other kind of SOFiCAD reinforcement object, we can always modify its properties through its AutoCAD properties or through its InfoEdit menu. The InfoEdit menu can be opened by double-clicking on the element or through right-clicking it with the mouse. For now, I still do not know how many bars of this position I am going to need, that is why I decide to switch off the displaying of the parameter number. I proceed in the same way for bar marks 1 and 2. I recommend using the commands copy, mirror and stretch as much as possible in order to improve our efficiency. Now, to determine the number of rebars of bar mark 3 and create its representation, we will create a linear rebar set. Let us call then the command arrow. The creation menu looks like the pointers one. But here, there is an extra option to determine the view type of the rebar set. In this case we are creating a front view. Just like with detail shapes, we are going to use formwork lines as reference. We are selecting the line, which our rebars must be perpendicular with. To determine the endpoint of the representation we also have several options, all of them displayed at the command bar. Now, just as an example, let's create a rebar set with the same configuration, but using a parallel reference line. I split the set in the middle. After finishing the rebar set, we can confirm that SOFiCAD has already calculated the needed number of bars. SOFiCAD would recalculate the number if we modify the properties of the rebar set. Linear rebar sets are not associated with the detail shape by default. That means, we can modify its representation without influencing the geometry of the corresponding bar mark. But if we want, we can activate its associativity through the option bar as profile. The next step in our project is to represent the bar marks 1 and 2 in the section view. For this, we need to create a rebar set with a fixed number of bars, in this case 4 bars. Instead of a distance between bars as input, section takes a number of bars, which will be placed equidistant along the reference line. Like in previous examples, we can use the command mirror and edit the properties in order to be more efficient. Finally, let us take a look at the total number of bars. As we see, too much bars have been counted for bar marks 1 and 2. That is because SOFiCAD cannot recognize the several representations of the same object on a plan. We can easily correct that with the command multiplier area with a value of 0. If we surround the objects of the section with the multiplier area x0, SOFiCAD will not count them and the total amount of element will be then right. I hope you have enjoyed creating rebar sets with SOFiCAD. In the next chapter I am going to show you how to easily edit existing reinforcement. Thank you for watching this tutorial.